What's up, Involvers? This is Bobby from Involve Me, and today we will have a look at how you can change the color of the progress bar in your Involve Me project. Let's jump right in. So the first thing you will need to do is head on over to the Involve Me app. And you need to create a new project. I am going to go with one from the templates. I'm going to go with Adopt a Pug because I really want a pug. So let's start editing. Then you will need to select your project type. By the way, if you're still confused about the different project types on Involve Me, make sure to check out our most recent video on YouTube. I will leave a link in the description box below. So once you are in your project, you will need to go to the top right corner of your screen and click on design. Then from there, you will need to click on project design. Project design is where you can change all the elements within your project. It's where you go if you don't just want to make a change on a single page, but you want to change everything about the project. So when you are in the general project design, you will need to scroll down to highlights. And highlights is what you need to change in order to change the color of your progress bar. So I'm feeling kind of funky today and fun, so I'm gonna go with neon blue. Perfect, that looks great. So now you will need to exit out of general project design and go to design preview. And as you can see at the top of your screen, the progress bar is now neon blue. But as you can also see, it changed several other buttons on the screen as well. And I don't really like that, so I'm gonna show you guys how to change that as well. So I'm just gonna exit out of preview mode. So in order to change the color of the buttons, you're gonna have to first click on the button, and then you will need to head on over to design. In design, there is this magical button called the Customize This Element Only, and you will need to turn that on. So once you turn it on, it's only going to change the design in that specific element, not the entire project. So you will need to change the background color. And I liked how the template was, and I liked the fact that it was black. So I'm just going to drag that color over to black. And I'm gonna do the same with the highlight. The highlight is when you hover over the button, and that's when that color pops up. So if you don't want the neon blue to be there when you hover over the certain element, then you need to change that as well to the specific color you want it to be. So I'm just gonna change this all to black. All right. Now, as you can see, the entire button is black and you can no longer see the title. So we're also going to have to change that in design and change the text color to white. Just how it was previously. And the highlights also to white. Perfect. So now, as you can see, the color of the button is back to the way it was originally. But up here, it's also still neon blue. So I'll just show you once again. You go to design and you turn on the Customize the Element, This Element Only button. You scroll down and you can see the color icon is neon blue, so we're just gonna go and drag it all the way to make it black, and it's back to the original design. So once you have finished changing the color of the element, there's this amazing button that will help you apply that same setting to all the rest of the buttons. So you will have to scroll down in design, and at the bottom of that tab it says apply settings for all button elements. You will click on that, and you will then click on customize all. Then, when you go to all the rest of your pages, those buttons will be the same color and style as the one you originally designed. And as you can see, it transferred it over to all the pages, which is amazing. So now, if you want to see the final product, you will click on Design Preview. And as you can see, when you click through, the progress bar is neon blue. But everything else in your project remain the same, or remain different if that's what you want. I don't know which one's the cutest. I think maybe waffles is my favorite. Anyways, that was it for today's video. Let me know in the comments down below which pug you would adopt, or any other questions or comments you still have. As always, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you thought it was helpful, and make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell so you're notified every time we post a new video. See you soon, bye!